Hey guys, this is Junior Trader, and in this video, we'll be taking a look at Apple, Microsoft, Google, Meta, Amazon, and Oracle stocks. We'll be doing price action analysis, taking a look at where do it make more sense, at what levels to either go long or short, and how we should be treating these stocks as for coming days and weeks. With that, please hit the like and subscribe if you like watching my videos, and let's see how we can make the most money in what directions with these stocks. So before jumping into specific stocks, I do want to cover QQQ, the NASDAQ 100 ETF, and I want to go over something very important with this. So it has been running into this critical one of the resistance levels at $370, and most of the rally that has been led by in the NASDAQ ETF, or more importantly actually, is also at XLK, the ETF that is mostly tied to these, you know, big IT sector stocks. And I'll be talking about that as well. Let's talk about QQQ right first. So this $370 level is one of the resistance that, you know, we should be keeping an eye on. This QQQ just went straight ripping through all other resistance levels that we had and has gone parabolic. So even at 334, you can see how it never did any pullback around this level, nor even at $353. It's a very, like a little to no pullback, right? And the stock has gone parabolic. So now it's running into this one of the very major resistance at $370 because of a lot of consolidation and a lot of previous pivot points. Now, this is being extended by definitely the IT sector, a lot of IT stocks like Apple, Nvidia, and so forth, right? Let's take a look at this XLK. It is technology, you know, SPY selective stocks, and you can see how it's testing its all-time highs in the parabolic move, right? It has gone parabolic, right? And little to no pullback at the resistance levels, even at 163. It actually used that as a support, right? So we are watching this level now, the level of all-time high, $176. RSI is running at very overbought territory. The last time this thing was all-time high up here was forming, you can see, bearish divergence. While the RSI was going up, RSI was going down, stock price was going up, and it finally capitulated. Right now, that is not happening though. Right now, the RSI is incrementally increasing as the stock price is also going up. So, however, let's see, I do feel like this will act as a huge resistance. Now, speaking of these two indices, let's talk about now the individual stocks on what we should be looking for and what directions we should be trading them out. So Apple very well has broken the all-time high, which is at right over here, $182.50. It has even formed a support on top of it and a breakout and is just looking to ride up, you know. We do have RSI just kind of chugging along at the top level, but for the positions, the level that we need to be watching for, let's jump to the hourly chart. And very well, if the stock price can still hold this $184 level as the support right over here, $184.31 is again a place to play, try to play it long as it can still hold above, guys, this 50 hours moving average on an hourly chart. Now, on the other hand, like, I really don't want to play Apple on the short side unless and until it breaks this 200 hours moving average, which is this red line. Otherwise, this will again can act as a support. So you can even try playing along on the pullback whenever it tests this 200 hours moving average. Break of 200 hours moving average might make us look on the short direction, but until then, nothing like that. Let's take a look at 30 minutes interval. So Apple seems to be more well in tune with the hourly chart. So let's just stick with the hourly chart on Apple, just because I was seeing the moves, how it has been forming, just so that the understandability is easier. All right, guys, so this is, you know, how I would be looking at the definitely important level for the bounce is $184 as a support. And then $182 might also act as support, and then support of 200 hours moving average. All right, Microsoft. So Microsoft, let's take a look on daily level first. It has broken all-time highs. If not, almost tested it. Yeah, it has broken all-time highs and has rejected that and is right now at least doing a pullback. We are not saying it's reversing. There is no sign of reversing. It's just doing a pullback. So, you know, let's see what its RSI is telling us. It's fine. It's not that super red hot, just how we had it back in November 2021. Even if it wanna reverse from here, guys, we do have to watch for certain levels of support and resistance. On daily level, it is still bullish as it is above 20, 50, and 200 days moving average. On the hourly level, let's see what the stock price is telling us. So it is not weak. I don't want to say that it's weaker. So 50 hours moving average can still act as a support on it. It has tried to form this bearishness before, like below 200 hours moving average, but has failed to have a follow through. It eventually just creeped its way up. And, you know, definitely then we should have a stop loss, right? That's why we have stop losses. And I would be more inclined only to play Microsoft short if it breaks again this 200 hours moving average to the downside. Until then, 200 hours moving average, 50 hours moving average is a good support level. The big support level, if Microsoft can hold $338, this is again a bounce play to the upside. Break of it to the downside might start giving a little bit of bearishness below $338, but then finally breaking 200 hours moving average is the confirmation we need to wait for to even try to play it on the short side and on hourly interval. Until then, you know, if you are not comfortable playing long at this place, then just stay patient. And other than that, I think, yeah, this level also becomes now our daily important levels. I'll just mark it blue. All right, guys, that was with Microsoft. Let's take a look at Google now. Google on the daily level, let's see what it's doing for us. So these were the breakout levels, you know, I marked as to play potentially to the next level, right? And this would have worked out in that fashion. This was like a few days ago I marked these levels. Let me mark them blue again because these are now daily level significance. So with Google, guys, it is consolidating at this point. Unless and until it does not break $126, I don't want to play it long. Google, for me, it's a short play. It's forming that way. It has broken this 20 days moving average again, and definitely below $123.97 gives us the play to $122, and further flush down below is $119, and then sequentially falling down below is what we would expect from Google. I'm not long biased on Google. It's forming to the short side. Let's take a look at hourly chart, what it's telling us. And yes, guys, very well on hourly actually, this is a really right place to try to play short with your stop loss above $123 because it is below 200 hours moving average, guys. As long as it stays below it, with your definitely will have stop loss on the other side. But if it stays below it, it's just the place to keep playing it short. That's how I'm reading Google, guys. All right, now let's jump onto Meta. So Meta is, analysts are still being bullish on it. And well, again, like analysts are analysts. They were talking bearishness when the stock price capped at $295 and they were saying, oh, Meta belongs at $150, right? Because it gapped up. So they were like, oh, it's a little bit creeping down. So, you know, let's just follow the price action. Now stock is going up. So they're just saying it's gonna keep going up, right? They always follow the price action so that they can maximize their moves. And it's just like, hey, just keep talking as long as people are buying into our thesis, right? They don't put any caution on, you know, where the RSIs are, what are the technicals telling us? Is it really at this time needs to be going this high? So, you know, they only work for themselves, right? It's like they have nothing to lose by pumping up the stock. But I'm not saying that Meta can't go higher. It may very well keep going higher, but we have to figure that out. Here. So let me just make a few adjustments real quick, guys, here These were, again, what some of the breakout and flush levels I provided in my community post. Definitely keep an eye on that, guys. On YouTube, I keep posting all of this stuff. And let's see what Meta is doing. So we had this gap all the way up to $289.05. It's just shy of it. Seems like it has filled it, but feels like it's just shy of it. That's, you know, it left a little bit of gap. But we'll see. So Meta right now, guys, is at least on daily level is bullish. Level to watch for is 274. If it comes back here, this could still be tried to play long intraday. It is definitely very extended, but it is what it is. You know, follow the trend. So definitely watch for $274.94. It's not looking bearish. We don't have any bearish confirmation. It's not below, you know, 20, 50, and 200 days moving averages on the upside of it. We have to jump to the hourly interval to talk more about it on the swing and intraday levels trading, what to look for. With Meta, guys, $288 might give you still intraday short play. I don't think it's going to just how it has fallen the very last few hours of the day. I don't think even if it's going to do a pullback that it's going to rip up from $289. I would be a little bit cautious to play Meta long here. You might want to wait for $274 level. If it never comes, it never comes, right? You just move on to other stocks. But we just got to making sure that do as what you are comfortable with, right? I would want to wait to see how Meta may again react around this 200 hours moving average and at this level of 274. Until then, I don't want to touch Meta. Definitely not on the short side because it's still above 50 hours moving average. That might still provide it some enough bounce that it keeps just creeping up. So we've got to wait for the break of this 50 hours moving average at least. And it's too extended on the long here. The gap you see, its extension right at this level without any confirmation. I don't really want to play long. Meta, just wait and see what it does. We not always want to take positions at every level. We got to see and wait when we see comfortable liquidity. So right now, I'm just not comfortable with Meta, but that's just my hunch. I already provided the levels that you can look at. So if you want to trade at those levels, it's your choice. Amazon, let's take a look at daily level first. And what are we seeing with Amazon? So again, we had these, you know, the levels provided right over here. Let me mark them intraday levels now. More likely, this will not be just intraday level. Let me just even check how much validity they hold. Yeah, guys, definitely it's consolidating here. Watch for $127. It's, well, technically it's still bullish on the daily interval. However, it feels like it's going to give us a pullback, but it doesn't want to do it. Guys, for this, actually, I want to do a volume profiling here. Let me see. Right. So it want to give us a pullback, but it doesn't look like that. It has that strength on the downside right now. It might stay choppy, guys, Amazon. Definitely, this type of stock is not my cup of tea when it's getting not super extended, but consolidating just halfway through. Because technically, the breakout of 127 to the long side is to be played on this one. Let's take a look at hourly interval and let's see what we are seeing here. Okay, so you can still have a short play on it if it breaks this 200 hours moving average to the downside. And if it breaks 127 to the upside, it's a long play. So that's how I would trade the stock. So watch these two levels, guys. Even if it stays below 125 and gives us the final confirmation of break off 200 hours moving average, then it's a short play. All right, that's how I'm reading Amazon. All right, guys, Oracle. So with Oracle, they had their great earnings, you know, and again, they came out with the news that, you know, AI is going to give them a lot of boost. NVIDIA is using their servers, you know, for inference and AI training. You can see the massive volume on Oracle and also RSI is overbought, but that's fine as long as price action is not confirming the downtrend. RSI is only taken to a grain of salt, but if we see patterns of, you know, reversal, that's when RSI also becomes important for the reversal side. Now with Oracle, what are we seeing, guys? Definitely another breakout, $123 of the previous highs, and it has formed a new high at $127.73. Let's mark that as well. Now it has rejected that level, but however, it's just a pullback as for what we are seeing. Let's jump to the hourly interval for more confluence on it, what we can be watching for. So definitely it's just way far away to even try to play it short. Not gonna play short Oracle. You need to wait. Look, all right, intraday, if you wanna look for opportunities for short, wait for the break of $123.76. That will give the break of this 50 hours moving average as well. However, break of 20 hours moving average and the break of $126.29 to the upside is a breakout play to the upside. That's how simply I would look at Oracle. It is not bearish on the swing side unless and until it breaks this 200 hours moving average on the downside. Period. Because this is where it has found the most confluence so far, and as long as it stays above it, it's going to stay above it. And this is what with Oracle, guys, how I would, you know, trade this stock. All right, guys, that was it for this video. I hope you found value in it. If you did, please hit the like and subscribe. With that, I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Bye.